My name is Quinn Calendar, and I am 12 years old and from Vancouver, BC, and I'm in Scouts. Okay, so right here you have the ear guard, as we are calling it, and you have these little hooks. So what you would do is you would put this on the back of your head, and you would take the straps from the mask, and you would just take and hook them over top so they fit inside of here, and you can adjust it however you want, and it just takes the straps off of the back of your ears and moves them further back so it doesn't cause you any stress. We have produced around 500 at the moment. Currently, anybody who lives kind of close to where we are can just drive down and pick them up off our porch. Otherwise, we can just mail it to them. I feel like during this time, this pandemic, where we have to stay at home in order to protect others, that we should try our best to contribute more to the people who are working to help stop this. So we heard back from the healthcare workers, and they said, well, they've all been very thankful that they can actually focus on their patients instead of the pain in the back of their ears. Because the posting that we originally had to kind of show what I was doing has gained a lot of attention.
My husband and I were so inspired by seeing a young Boy Scout print ear guards for medical masks, so we used the design file to start printing them from our 3D printer.
Well, the file has been downloaded over 60,000 times, and that means that people from around the world have begun to print out these ear guards and have donated them to their local hospitals and medical professionals.
And the cool thing too is that because of all the publicity he's had from it, we've been approached by a few manufacturers, and one in particular from Michigan in the US has now started turned their operation towards this and is donating thousands and is actually shipping us 10,000 units within the next week so that we can distribute those across Canada.
It made me feel great that I can contribute to the people who are risking their lives to help save ours, and we'll just try and help until we don't need to. Just try and find out what you can do in your community and work towards achieving whatever may be the problem. So to anyone who would like to help for this cause, if you happen to have a 3D printer that is available to use, the file should be easy to find, and just try and print out as many as you can and donate them to your local hospital or medical professionals. When people say that you're too young to make a difference, I tell them, watch me.